Hey everyone, I am Carissa Wright, Broker Associate at Beach City Brokers in Redondo Beach. And today we are going to talk about the city of Rolling Hills. I'm really excited to do this video. Rolling Hills is actually my favorite city on the Palos Verdes Peninsula. So let's go ahead and dive in. But first, if you haven't already, please hit subscribe. New videos coming out weekly talking about the South Bay, Palos Verdes, and real estate, as well as other fun things. All right, let's jump in. So the area that is Rolling Hills, I always tell people it's kind of like the top middle of the peninsula. It's approximately 3 square miles, which is about 1920 acres. And Rolling Hills roughly extends from Palos Verdes Drive North, which is Rolling Hills Estates area bordering Rolling Hills, all the way up to the top of the peninsula to Crest, and then it extends down the south side of the peninsula to the hillside above Portuguese Bend area and Rancho Palos Verdes, as well as Crenshaw Boulevard on the east side. Now, Rolling Hills is extremely unique because it is a guard-gated city. So what does that mean? There are only 3 entrances, and those 3 entrances are also the only 3 exits. So 3 entrances and exits in and out of the city. And these entrances are guard gated 24/7. So 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, holidays included, there are always guards at every single gate. And so that is why I say it's an exclusive city. You must be a resident to enter Rolling Hills or be listed as a visitor on a homeowner's guest pass. So there's 3 gates, like I said. There is the main gate, which is off of Portuguese Bend and Palos Verdes Drive North. There's the Crest Gate, which is located more at the top of Rolling Hills along Crest Road. And then there's the Eastfield Gate, which is located along Eastfield and Palos Verdes Drive East, more in the Miraless RPV area. Now, Rolling Hills is a really, really unique city. I always tell people that you're in Rolling Hills and you feel like you are in the middle of the country, but yet you are actually right in LA, in LA County. You know, let's say on a good day, it could take you 30 minutes to get to downtown LA from Rolling Hills. So you feel like you're in the middle of nowhere, but you're really right in the middle of it. Close to the beach, close to downtown LA, close to the west side, close to Orange County. So it's a really, really unique city. And they love to preserve the rural and equestrian feel of Rolling Hills. So it is just absolutely beautiful. It's green. There's rolling hills everywhere, obviously. It's a lot of hilly terrain, wooded canyons. It's just a really beautiful, lush, green city. And Rolling Hills should always stay this way. That is really the plan of this city, is to keep it with this rural feeling. Now, there are no traffic lights. There's no commercial buildings. There's no multifamily housing. There's only single family homes in the entire city of Rolling Hills. So again, very rural feeling. And most of the homes sit on multi-acre lots. Again, most of the lots are a minimum of 1 acre, but most average, I'd say, is about 2.5 acres. All right, so let's go ahead and jump into some of my favorite interesting facts about Rolling Hills. Now, Rolling Hills is an extremely small city when it comes to the number of homes and the population. So there's about 685 homes in Rolling Hills, and the population is actually less than 2,000. Now, Rolling Hills is guided by 2 entities, the City of Rolling Hills and the Rolling Hills Community Association, and they both have their own distinct governing body, so they are completely separate entities. Now, Rolling Hills Community Association is a homeowners association, so every single homeowner does have association dues, and the dues are based off of the assessed value of your home. So it's not one general amount for every homeowner. Now, how do we calculate this? HOA dues are based off of, again, your assessed value. So 20 cents per $100 of assessed value, and it's made in 2 payments annually. Now, public safety, the police department that corresponds with Rolling Hills is the Los Angeles County Sheriff's Department. So that's really nice to have. And then fire is LA County. And there is actually 1 firehouse located behind the gates, as we often say about Rolling Hills. 1 firehouse behind the gates in Rolling Hills, located up near the top of Crest Road and Portuguese Bend. Now, let's talk about the houses and the styles. Another really interesting thing about Rolling Hills is that all of the homes, with one exception, are single level, ranch style, white homes. Now, let's break this down a little bit. Single level. Sometimes now you actually are able to build under your home, so you can go subterranean. But from the street level, your home is supposed to look like a single level, not a two-story house. Ranch, again, single level, spread out ranch house. This is still very much true. And then white. Now, most of the homes, another interesting thing to note is that they are on septic tanks. And a lot of times I find that clients are at first intimidated by this, but working with an agent like myself who sells often in Rolling Hills, we can really explain to you how septic tanks work if you're not already familiar, and how to make it kind of an easy process for you and your family going forward living there. All fences, all border fences around your home must be white three rails, so you know that horse looking fence. And again, minimum lot size 1 acre, with the average being 2.7 acres, as I mentioned earlier. Now, in comparison to some of the other parts of PV, Rolling Hills is generally considered to be just Rolling Hills. There's no neighborhoods per se, but in an attempt to help you to really understand the lay of the land of Rolling Hills, I'll do my best to break this down for you a little bit. Now, as I mentioned, there are three gates. So if we start up at the very top of Rolling Hills at the Crest Gate, this is on the top northern side of the city, I would say, and borders Rancho Palos Verdes. This area, oftentimes the homes have amazing views of Catalina. Sometimes they'll have amazing views on the other side facing downtown LA, Los Angeles Basin views, and maybe even some of the Queen Necklace views. Now, if you go to the other side of Rolling Hills, where the Eastfield Gate is, it's a little bit further from, let's say, the main gate or the Crest Gate. And you might have views of the LA Harbor, Long Beach, maybe some downtown LA basin views. Maybe there's some peekaboo Queen's Necklace sometimes, but for the most part, you're gonna be looking more south, more towards Orange County from the Eastfield side. Now, I will say homes on the Eastfield side of Rolling Hills oftentimes inches tops versus the actual naturally occurring landslide that's happening in Rancho Palos Verdes. That one sees quite a bit of movement in some parts of that. The good thing about being in the Flying Triangle, in addition to the views, is that it has the lowest priced homes in Rolling Hills. So if someone is really desperate to get into Rolling Hills, but they can't afford a traditional home, then oftentimes you can start out in the Flying Triangle neighborhood and get a little bit more bang for your buck. Now, amenities. One of the great things about Rolling Hills is that there are amenities, and this is a part of the Rolling Hills Community Association, the dues that you pay as a homeowner. So there are two riding rinks for the residents, horse riding rinks, that is. There are two tennis courts and two pickleball courts. There's also 25 miles of trails. Now, these trails are used for horses, hiking, walking, running. There's absolutely no motorized vehicles allowed on these trails. And there's also a lot of events that are held every year. There's like an Easter egg hunt sometimes. Sometimes there's some sledding around Christmas time. So a lot of fun events. And then there's some clubs as well. There's a women's club, the Caballeros Club, the tennis club. And these clubs, as a resident, you are able to join. And these clubs also host various events and meetings and get-togethers throughout the year. So a lot of opportunities to get involved in the city of Rolling Hills. Schools. There's actually no schools within the city of Rolling Hills. So, one exception to this. There is a continuation of high school known as Rancho Del Mar, and the address is Rolling Hills, but it's actually located outside of the Crest Gate. So, students who attend Rancho Del Mar actually do not enter into Rolling Hills. They just go right past the Crest Gate to where their campus is. So for children who live in Rolling Hills Elementary, you are assigned to Dapplegray Elementary typically, which is in Rolling Hills Estates. Middle school, you're going to be assigned to Miraless, and high school, as with all of the all the areas in PV, you get to select your high school. So PV High or Peninsula High School. I'd say in terms of proximity, you're probably closer to Peninsula High School. With that being said, I know a lot of students who still choose to go to PV High. So you have your option with which high school you want to attend. Now, home prices. We're going to look at the last 6 months of home prices. So I said earlier, it's a small city. So within the last 6 months, there's only been 15 homes that have sold. The lowest sale was $2,250,000 for a two-bed, two-bath home, which was 1,467 square foot, sitting on a little less than an acre, so a little less than the standard minimum acre requirement. The highest sale was $6,995,000. This was for a six-bedroom, eight-bath, 12,000 square foot home, sitting on 7 acres. And the average sale was about $4 million for a four-bed, four-bath, 4,000 square foot home sitting on 2 acres. So average price in Rolling Hills is $4 million. Average price per square foot, we're looking at about $1,200. I will just say real quick, I absolutely hate Rolling Hills based on average price per square foot because homes in Rolling Hills are all so extremely unique. There are no tracks. And so it is really important to work with a realtor who's experienced in Rolling Hills because we really understand the layout of the land, and we're not gonna just come in and do a price per square foot on homes, which you literally cannot do. But as a buyer, just to give you an idea of what you're looking at price-wise in Rolling Hills. All right, and as we wind down, I wanna just touch real quick on my last things, which are the interesting facts about Rolling Hills. Now, leash-free city. So if you are a dog owner, a lot of people love this. And it's mostly due to the fact that Rolling Hills is an equestrian city, but if you have a well-behaved off-leash dog, it is always so nice to be able to walk the trails with your dog. So leash-free city, you can't be ticketed for it. No motorcycles. So if you're a visitor and or a guest, you have someone on your guest pass coming into the city for the day, they may not come in on a motorcycle. There are residence restrictions if you own your own motorcycle. And this is all due to the fact that Rolling Hills really wants to keep the feeling of a rural community, and they don't want a lot of noise issues. Last thing, it is a smoke-free city, so no cigarette smoke. So as I have mentioned, Rolling Hills is such an extremely unique and, in my opinion, very, very, very beautiful city. And if you are looking to buy or sell, or you know somebody who is, it is so extremely important to work with a realtor who is extremely experienced in this city, has lived there possibly, as myself and my partners have, and also have sold in Rolling Hills. There's so many restrictions about home ownership there in terms of what you can build, what you can do, and it takes a lot of years and experience knowledge to really understand this unique Rolling Hills market. Now, that is it. Thank you so much for checking out my Rolling Hills video. And if you have ever visited Rolling Hills, I'd be really curious to hear what your favorite part of Rolling Hills is. And if you haven't, please leave any questions that you have about the city of Rolling Hills in the comments. And again, thank you so much for checking out my video.